The first time was intense.
Oh, we just put it all out there.
Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. So today's a story time video and we're going to talk about the very first time we
were vegan activists. What else did you think we were going to talk about?
So it's timely that we're making this video now because a few days ago on the 26th of August marked our 5-year anniversary as vegans.
Rewind the clock 5 years and we were in Thailand teaching yoga. There wasn't much work on because it was the low season and so we were watching YouTube as
of
you
course.
Do.
Yep, and we were vegetarian at the time and actually one of our yoga students had sent us a link to, I think it was a BBC documentary about veganism. And we were watching that was quite good. And then along the suggested videos was
a video called Best Speech You'll Ever Hear, which of course is gonna get your attention. Yeah. If that doesn't, nothing else will.
That's right, and excellent clickbait. And we thought, well, we clicked on it, of
exactly.
course.
And then we're like, an hour, oh.
No way, we said we'd give it 10 minutes.
Exactly.
Well, we watched the full thing.
We did, yeah. An hour later, we were vegan.
Yeah, so we got to the end of the video and it was very, it was a difficult one to watch.
There were a lot
of truths in there. We were all already vegetarian, moving towards veganism for health, but we had not made the ethical connection. So we got to the end and what happened? We were in tears.
We were. Yeah, gave each other a hug.
Yeah, it was emotional.
It was. Mm. I remember a cat came in at that time.
Yes. Amazing.
As they do in Thailand. Just come into the restaurant.
Of course. So the story behind the cat is that I have had a lifelong fear of cats and I'm still pretty scared of them. For me, they are just way too smart.
Yeah, they are.
They're just really intelligent and scary. So I've always stayed away from cats. And we get to the end of the film, the video, we're crying. The cat comes in. And it comes straight towards us. Mm. In fact, straight towards me.
Yeah.
And it starts rubbing itself on my leg. And I'm like, oh my God, it's an animal. We've just watched Gary's speech. We've just decided we've gone vegan and an animal's coming. It's a sign.
And it was comforting you, wasn't it?
It was. It was comforting me. And it was the first time I reached down and I started to pat it. It was the first time I'd ever touched a cat. And I was bawling my eyes out. And I kept saying, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
And that was your way of saying I'm sorry to all of your kin, all animals that I've, you know, contributed towards the murder of needlessly.
Yeah, for my entire life. Yeah. Exactly. And it's like this cat was just, as you said, comforting me and forgiving us in a way as well. It's like, it's all right.
Clean slate.
Clean slate.
You've made the connection now.
Yeah.
Your life starts now.
Yeah. So that was a pretty big wow moment. I don't think I've ever touched a cat since then. I don't think they've come near me since then. But I do thank that cat for that moment.
But the main point of this story is to share with you what we did about 5 minutes after watching the Gary's video on deciding to go vegan. Because a lot of vegans go vegan and, you know, they remain quiet about it. And of course, the most important thing is that you go vegan.
Yeah.
But then we always like to encourage vegans whenever possible to be as vocal about it as possible, because in doing so, that's how we're going to save the most number of animals' lives, by encouraging others to go vegan. And of course, if we don't talk about it, that's not going to happen as fast as it otherwise could.
Yeah, so the big mouths here. We decided that we had a moral obligation to share this video that we just watched that changed our lives with everybody we knew, of course. So we sent an email to every single person in our contacts list.
So we're talking, you know, somewhere between 150 and 200 from memory.
And this is what it said.
Dear all, we've literally sent this email to everyone in our contacts list. Some of you we haven't had contact with for years, others we've only met once. Yet it doesn't matter, we feel passionate about this topic and morally obligated to send this link to every single person we could. We won't tell you what it's about because some of you will choose not to watch it. Instead, we challenge you to change the world by clicking on the link and then forwarding it on to everyone in your contacts list. This will save your life and the lives of others, not to mention the planet. We've made the change and hope you join us. Please give this video your time. With love and respect, Natasha and Luca.
So we can remember actually writing that email and
we spent a bit of time articulating it perfectly so as to offend as few people as possible.
Yeah, and we didn't actually put the word vegan in the email or in the title. It was like, oh, what's this all about? And we felt morally obligated. Like we we knew that we had to send this, yeah, and there was nothing that was going to stop us.
So the heart was racing a little bit because, yeah, of course, you know, it was not confrontational, but you know,
you're putting yourself out there. Yeah. You know, it's like your first time going, hey world, we're vegan now and you should be too, and here's why.
Yeah. But as you said, the moral obligation was so strong that it wasn't even a question, should we? We just knew we had to.
And we were a little sweaty pressing the send button, admittedly, but once you do it the first time,
easy.
And we didn't care what the result was. And this is the moral of the story. The response that we got back then, 5 years ago, is still the same thing that we're getting today.
So basically, you're going to get the good, the bad, yes, and the ugly.
And everything in between.
Exactly. Here are some examples. Yes. I don't think we've ever really had contact. Watched the entire video and the Q&A session. Cried my eyes out while watching the Ohio dairy farm video he showed. I'm from Ohio. I'm also vegetarian, meaning I drink milk and love yogurt and frozen yogurt. Now I feel a slight headache and swelling of the eyes just thinking about how much of my money goes to support that Ohio dairy farm and all dairy farms than it does to support my drive to go scuba diving or run a marathon. I've yet to do either. Living in a capitalist nation, I know how to make my vote. So I'll miss the taste of cow's milk, but I can surely live with almond milk to avoid knowing that I'm supporting sadistic and sanguinary businesses. So thank you, Natasha and Luca, whoever you two are. I will now be sending this talk to my parents, then to everyone in my contacts as well. Didn't think my Friday was going down this route, but I can be flexible. Haha.
So that's the best case scenario, but you also get the opposite extreme. This is from a person who actually works with underprivileged children. So he has a very big heart. He has a lot of compassion for humans, but he can't seem to extend that to non-human animals. He responded with, after 9 minutes, 21 seconds, I had to turn it off. Heard it all before. And he was actually vegetarian previously and had gone back to eating meat. He continues by saying,
I would have to disagree that this is the best speech ever. Martin Luther King's I Have a Dream or Churchill's Fight Them on the Beaches were far more important and far more interesting. I wonder how many of the audience listening to his speech went out for a burger once it was over.
Yeah, yeah. Yapping. And we've heard that many times before.
I'm still,
yeah?
Hearing it 5 years
still
later.
Still hearing it.
The point is, you can't control how anyone is going to react. The only thing you can do is control your actions and actually put the information out there. Then you have to detach from the result and walk away knowing that you've planted the seed and hope that it grows either now or in the future.
Yeah, and you have to detach from the result because it will drive you insane. And initially, yeah, I remember receiving these emails, these responses, and we were like, yes, oh my God, no, what? Come on. You know, it was just this roller coaster. Of emotions from us, but as an activist, that's going to drive you crazy and it's not sustainable. It's exhausting. Mm. So it's really important, as Luca said, plant the seed and walk away from it.
We just want to reiterate that, of course, you don't have to be an activist in order to be vegan. The most important thing is that you're vegan. Yeah. And of course, there are many ways to be an activist. You don't have to be so in people's faces like we were with that email.
Yeah, here's our email. Do it.
Exactly. You know, there are more subtle ways. You can leaflet where, you know, nobody actually sees you putting the leaflets in the letterbox, for example. Or you could hand them out in person if that's your thing, but you don't really necessarily need to communicate with the person.
Exactly. Even just having an Instagram account showing your lovely, colorful vegan food, that's a way of getting people interested, creating conversations online. So lots of different options. This is just what we did 5 minutes after going vegan, but you know, whatever floats your boat. So that's our story, guys, of how we popped our vegan activist cherry. And now it's time to hear from you guys. Put your story down below. How did you first become a vegan activist? And let's encourage others to want to speak up as well.
Exactly. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And remember that until next time, going vegan is not the most we can do.
It's the least we can do. And we can also speak up for animals, people, and the planet. See you next video.
Bye, guys.
Just don't understand what point animals and trees and whales' lives were more important than human lives.
They're not more important. All those things matter equally. But if, for example, we had to put those things in an order of